Teachers in Wisconsin called in sick, closing schools and marching on the Capitol, angered by the governor's threat to end collective bargaining and gut the union.
We have to kill this bill. If this bill passes, it is the end of collective bargaining for all public employees, and then really it'll be the end of collective bargaining for all employees.
New Jersey's governor also striking out, targeting the teachers' union pushback on education reform.
I'm attacking the leadership of the union because they're greedy and they're selfish and self-interested.
Even New York City's mayor, who has made education a top priority, he too was playing hardball, telling the state to cough up hundreds of millions of dollars or else.
The budget assumes that we will lose about 6,000 teachers through layoffs and attrition. We need the state to step up and do our part.
Crushing budget shortfalls nationwide have created a unique opportunity. A handful of governors mixing education reform with budget cuts, arguing there's no money to maintain the status quo. What education watchers call a perfect storm of three things: budget shortfalls, schools in dire need of reform, and Republican governors.
It's hard to tell whether some of these actions are specifically related towards improving education or whether they're just trying to kind of tackle or take on the public sector unions, the teacher unions.
Kill the bill! Kill the bill!
In Wisconsin, that means having teachers pony up more pension and health care costs. In places like Florida, Michigan, Idaho, and New York City, it means taking aim at teacher tenure to keep better teachers, not those who have been there longest.
We cannot wait any longer to take on the tough issues once and for all.
Teachers saying they and their students will be the ones who unfairly bear the brunt.
This is something we hear continually. Every day when I'm in schools, the teachers constantly tell me, you know, we feel completely disrespected.
Now, ideally, teacher tenure, for example, which is really under attack, makes it harder for teachers to be dismissed arbitrarily for things like race, gender, age, nepotism. It's really too early to tell right now, Candy, whether there's a silver lining in any of all this. But really, this is something that we're seeing nationwide because there's simply no money. So governors, mayors, they have to change things so that they can make their budgets.